Good morning, and welcome to our worship on this, our ecumenical worship on this Remembrance Day. We will begin our liturgy with the singing of O Canada, so please stand as you're able and sing our national anthem. Almighty God, grant that we who gather here today may pay fitting tribute and honor to the memory of those who have died in service of their country. May we be so inspired by the spirit of their love and courage that, forgetting all selfish and unworthy motives, we may live only to your glory and to the service of your people. May we who desire peace be willing to work for justice. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Remaining standing as you're comfortable. If you're not comfortable, please do sit. We're going to sing O God, Our Help in Ages Past, which is number 528 in your blue hymn book.
Thank you. Please be seated. A reading from Isaiah. In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and shall be raised above the hills. All the nations shall stream to it. Many peoples shall come and say, "Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths." For out of Zion shall go forth instruction and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations and shall arbitrate for many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sin. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we ought also to love one another. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God.
Seeds over the seas of mud. then the nitrogen in the explosives, and from the decaying remains of animals and soldiers. Fertilize them. As British poet Isaac Rosenberg describes in his poem Break of Day in the Trenches, their roots were in dead men's veins. And soldiers picked them from the parapets, signs of life in fields of death. Rosenberg speaks of poppies dropping as they're blasted out of the soil. But he says of the one that he picked up, that he picked off the top of his trench and tucked behind his ear, "Mine in my ear is safe, just a little white in the dust." For him, his poppy is a small blessing, something to hold and keep safe, perhaps a sign of hope. This blessing flourished in a wounded landscape. In this way, they may literally be blessings, because our English word comes from the French word for wounding, or wound, blessure. Blessings come from wounds. The story of the poppies may also reveal an ironic version of Isaiah's vision, as the weapons of war, for a moment, turn to plowshares, serve to plow and seed the landscape, despite themselves. There's something here, too, about resilience, of a landscape intent on returning to life, of God's vision of the blessings of freedom and peace. When Jesus tells us, "Blessed are the peacemakers," I think he's pointing out just how hard peacemaking is. We may be wounded in the attempt, but driven to trying again, being resilient in its pursuit until this blessing is everyone's. Remembering, too, is a blessing, because from it comes both pain and honor. Through our poppies, we remember all of those whose vision over a century ago was never again. We will remember them, and we will not do this again. And all those who have suffered them, offered themselves for that vision, many returning wounded in body or soul, or not returning at all. Even as we have fallen away from this vision again and again. We remember John's challenging reminder that we are all beloved of God and Jesus and to each other. We remember war, and just as the prophet Isaiah nearly three millennia ago saw a vision of weapons turned to tools and nations battled together in love on God's holy mountain, we envision peace. Remembering the resilience of the poppy, we nurture space for the blessing of peace to grow. Amen. I would invite you to stand as you're comfortable, and we will sing hymn number 505, Be Thou My Vision. Thank you.
As is well known, that Legion honor list is maintained at our branch 49.
Before I read the now famous poem by Lieutenant John McRae, it's good to remember that the poem, which is actually unique in the way it was written as if the dead were actually speaking it. So wherever anybody today is reading this poem around the world, they will be speaking as if it's those that were actually dead. So you might try and think in your mind as the words are said, exactly what the poet was saying on behalf of those soldiers. In Flanders Fields by Lieutenant Colonel John McRae, Canadian Army. In Flanders Fields the poppies blow, between the crosses row on row that mark our place, and in the sky the larks, so bravely singing, fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt dawn saw sunset glow, love and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw the torch, be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep. the poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Holy One, we come before you now with praise and thanksgiving, as well as sorrow and concern in our hearts. With gratitude on this Remembrance Day, we call to mind the soldiers, sailors, and their personnel, all who have paid the ultimate price that we might live in freedom. We remember those who died in distant wars and those who are recent. By sacrificing their lives, they left us the responsibility and the duty to continue their work on the things that make for peace. From generation to generation, may their valor and selflessness never be forgotten. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We are especially mindful today of the effects of military life on the body, mind, and spirit. Give courage, comfort, and healing to all those who suffer wounds, both visible and invisible. Help us to remember that the effects of conflict reach far beyond the battlefield and can last a lifetime. enable us to provide the support our service members need to live happy and healthy lives. May our commitment to them be as full and complete as their commitment to serve Canada before self. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Lest we forget, the families and friends of our service members share in the burdens of military life. Bring comfort and strength to the relatives and friends of those who serve. When they are grieving the loss of their loved ones, may they know your compassionate and comforting presence. When they are separated from one another due to deployments or other operational requirements, may their bonds be strengthened. When their lives are uprooted because they are posted to a new location and everything is new all over again, may they be upheld by the constancy of your steadfast love. Accompany them in their daily joys and protect them in difficulties. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May our act of remembrance this day honor those who have put themselves in harm's way for the safety of others. May we never forget their sacrifice, the families who grieve for them and support them, and their example of integrity, loyalty, courage, and duty. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
As people of faith, we recommit ourselves to work together for peace in our world. May the hope that we carry in our hearts lead us to seek new and creative ways to resolve our differences. We look forward to that day when your reign is fully recognized among us, and swords are turned into plowshares, and nations no longer lift up sword against nation. God, in your mercy.
We also long for the moment when mourning, suffering, and sickness are no more. Until that day comes, we ask that you respond to us as we lift. As we lift before you in the silence of our hearts the names of those people, places, and situations that are in need of your tender, loving care this day. We pause. Restore them to health and wholeness, O God. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask all of these things in the name of the one who came to show us your ways, who taught us to pray together, saying, Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Having gathered, remembered, heard, given, and prayed, we ask God for God's blessing and for God's continual presence in our lives. God, remind us that no matter where we go, you are there. No matter how bleak the world becomes, all it takes is one ray of light for a new day to once again be with us. Amen. Please stand as you are comfortable.